chocolate can be comforting in hard times, but if you turn to British chocolate for support, you might need to begin stockpiling fast. Vladimir Duthiers is here looking at a looming ban. Vlad, good morning.
Good morning. For more than 30 years, importers of British goods brought English Cadbury chocolate into the United States. But as a lawsuit between the American chocolate behemoth Hershey and the British importers draws to a close, fans of milky English bars of chocolate are anticipating a permanent dry spell.
Luscious, tempting, sinful. Chocolate is addictive. There's a reason why the world equates chocolate with love. Joe Allegretti comes to Myers of Keswick in Manhattan's West Village for his fix.
English Cadbury is better than American Cadbury. I have said that for years.
And London expat Matthew James Thomas seems to agree.
American chocolate is just not quite there yet.
Would you want these?
Yeah. With the ban against British milk chocolate looming, near panic is setting in.
We're laying our hands on all the Cadburys that we can until the ban actually takes effect.
The first ingredient listed on this, milk.
Nikki Perry and her husband Sean Kavanaugh Downsett own Tea and Sympathy, an English grocery and tea shop in New York City.
This is a global world now. You can't turn around to us and say all of a sudden we can't have bars of chocolate.
Hershey has owned the rights to make Cadbury in the U.S. for nearly 30 years and has largely ignored specialty shops selling the British version. But after noticing those stores were taking an increasing bite of the company's $7 billion business, Hershey sued to stop all imports into the U.S.
I actually really don't understand it, because with all that's happening today, is it really that important to be banning chocolate?
Tastes like chocolate never tasted before. Just let me know when I'm going to get arrested for selling chocolate, because I would
love to have you guys with the camera here.
On the camera as they lead me off for the, you know, selling chocolate. This is ridiculous.
Well, they would say it's not selling chocolate. They would say that you're infringing.
Nonsense. We're not infringing on anything.
Have you ever seen fudge done this way?
Jim St. John is senior director of product development at Hershey's and says the recipes are almost identical.
I would say that the product that we sell in the United States is extremely similar to the product sold in England, and that consumers would be delighted by either.
Not so, say the lovers of British Cadburys. They point to the ingredients to make their argument. British Cadbury's defines milk chocolate as milk, sugar, and then cocoa butter. The American as sugar, milk, then chocolate. Tiny differences, but they leave the British palate unsatisfied.
I mean, I don't know how you got this in.
We called on food writer and chocolate aficionado Bill Buford to put this claim to the test. First, the English Cadbury.
What are you tasting?
It tastes of milk. But if you can imagine this like as a warmed up in a cup on a cold morning in the mountains, this is like the bar equivalent of a steamy cup of hot chocolate.
And it really has a, it sticks to the roof of your mouth. It's not very easy to swallow at first.
No, no, no.
As for the Cadbury made in the U.S.,
well, I have to say that it's not bad.
No.
It is a subtle difference. It is a subtle difference.
It has nothing to do with what's better. It's not only personal preference, but there's also a very sentimental idea, which is that if you grew up with this,
right,
this is England, mate.
And therein lies the issue. While the battle may be playing itself out in a Yankee court, in the end, what's at stake may really be more a matter of hearts and minds.
It's kind of like a nationalistic food. It's, you know, it's hot dogs on the 4th of July.
Is that it? Yes.
There's all sorts of reports you can read in studies where they say that chocolate triggers something in the human mind, and it releases a certain level of endorphins and it's sense memory and all these different things.
You're trying to tell me that chocolate's orgasmic.
Well,
which
are
it
you
is?
Trying to tell me that, Sean?
All right, so the final settlement in the Hershey's lawsuit will be reached in several weeks. Now, the main importers of British Cadbury chocolate will pay a fine and be banned from bringing over the chocolate, thereby ending the British threat to America's sweeter tooth. But before we go, I brought some chocolate here for everybody to try. You guys
will. Gail and I know which one is which right now, but okay. Nora doesn't. So, okay, I know which one you're eating right there.
Well, I have something on the inside.
Well, one's English, one's American.
Yeah, you have to see if you can tell the difference. Okay, you don't like that one. Try the other one.
I'm going to guess that's the American.
It is.
Why do you think
that? Better?
It doesn't have that stuff on the inside. I don't know. This is more sugary.
You can feel the sugar,
the
right?
The American one is sugary, you're saying.
Yeah.
Okay, thanks.
Right?
Nora, too Nora, bad you're not in charge of the court
case. It's very British.
Nora likes America. We'll be right back.
Woo! Go America!